So I'm really happy to have with me today Sophie Linenbaum, and Pinky Promise is a short film which was written and directed by her. The film, which action takes place in a posh restaurant where a family of three is eating a sophisticated dinner. The film turns into a farce in the moment when the waiter wants to collect the daughter's finger that the father promised him for his tartlet. I would like to start with the title. While it's English version, I feel Pinky Promise is quite clear. It's a reference to the tiny finger and small promises that we all make unconsciously and at the same time break very easily. But the German title, Das Mensch, sounds a little bit more complicated. You're kind of making inhuman out of the human, changing der Mensch into a thing, das thing. Could you explain why such a choice of title?
I think you nearly explained it perfectly by asking it. it's kind of the combination of the most superficial human and dehumanizing it at the same point. Being so perfectly by following the rules that you start losing the humanity.
Okay. Yeah, that's the feeling that you get when you watch the parents in the restaurant and how they interact with the girl. You studied psychology. I did the research. You studied psychology, and once watching your film, there is this thinking of moral responsibility of keeping promises, that agreements should be kept or must be kept, and this is somehow distinguishing us from animals. But at the same time, there is this feeling that you can't help that this film could have ended well. The parents could have simply said, yeah, okay, we made a mistake. We will not keep this promise. The waiter is simply mirroring their behavior that they do towards the child, towards them. And in the end, the consequences have to be paid by the child once again. Could you tell us something more about this pedagogical feeling and this of the film?
Oh, it's interesting that you called pedagogical, but maybe it is. Yeah, that's true, because I feel bad when you say that, because now I feel like a stupid teacher, but I think you are kind of right, because when I make films, I love to talk with people about things that touch me, and the moral topic you talk about, that really got me when I studied psychology, because when you start studying it, or at least when I started, we first learned people are bad. There are so many examples for people, when they are bad, why they are bad, and so many examples we all know, especially when you're German, you know them. And you know that there's a big mass movement of bad people when you're German. So I think there's this German topic of following rules that might not be the best rules when you look back in history. So I think that's, and because it might be absurd and it might be it might seem absurd to bring it to an end, but I feel like our society has so many absurd things that they bring to an end every day, and so many absurd rules about exploitation, for example, that are so normal every day for us, and that we fight for our right to, for example, that is, I don't know why I come to this example right now, but our right to buy cheap things and make others work for it who don't earn. So I think society is so much more absurd than our films are. So I had to bring it to the end.
Yeah, and at the same time, following rules is what keeps the society together. If we would not believe that people will follow the rules and will keep the promises, then the basis of the society don't have any right to exist. So it makes us feel safe.
I'm so with you at that point. That's why I was interested in the topic, because there's a big part of me that's like, yeah, go with it. You promised, you have to do it. And I really like to explore this field between wrong and right, and it's not that easy. And that's because if it would be easy, life would be not boring. I would love it to be easy. I would love it to have a life where you would like, okay, that's black, that's white, go there and do it. But I think that's where life comes to the points where we need to discuss, where we need to talk about it. And what I said before, that there were strict rules, and there are always strict rules at different times. And when you look back, you think about, okay, what seemed right at that time, when you look at it now, it's completely different now. And so there's this really clever sentence of Hannah Arendt, and she said there's nobody has the right to obey. And I think that's what the film is about. Never stop thinking, which doesn't mean their rules are bad.
Yeah, and questioning the reality and questioning the rules. Yeah. Your film also has a little bit of theatrical touch to it. The actors exaggerate the reactions and mimics and the dialogues, especially when the main conflict arises. They resemble a little bit of theatrical play. Was it a deliberate decision of yours?
Yeah, I'm really interested in this. Like, I'm interested in this combination of good and bad. I'm interested in this field of experimenting with absurdity and naturalism. So I try to find a way to combine it and to have this, because I think it would be dishonest to play the situation without a slightly absurd feeling in the characters themselves. I wouldn't buy it. So yeah, I try to, because I buy the feelings in some way, but in another way, I still know it's a situation we put up together. So yeah.
Okay. Yeah, the whole story is such a farce and has such a specific topic that mostly is not really happening to us in the real life. That the whole style of it simply matches, and yeah, I think that it would also work very well if it would be somewhere in the theater. It would also translate very well. Okay, thank you very much for answering these questions, and the Q&A will appear right after the film, so it's always good to have some additional thoughts and so on to think about the film. The film was also screened, I saw, during Etude and Anima in Krakow. So it's been to Poland already before, and now it will be on our online festival. So this is really good to still stay with the films and to continue our work, although the society and the world around us is really changing rapidly. But yeah, thank you. Thank you for agreeing to screen the film, and thank you for being part of our festival.
Yeah, I hear you. And thank you very much for showing Pinky Promise. And I really thank you for this nice Q&A and for this intelligent questions. I can tell you made your work, and you're a clever reader and watcher.
Thank you. Thank you.